2020 was rough. This time last year, we had high hopes and goals. We weren't ready for a worldwide pandemic, for the struggles we would face. How could we have been? We were pushed to our limits. We were beaten down, unprepared for what 2020 had in store. How can we get ourselves to look forward to a better year, a new year that could fill us with disappointment, anger, and sadness all over again? The world isn't fair. It's ugly, mean, and unforgiving. I would like to say this year will be better, but it might not be. All we can do is prepare for it. We can prepare to be brought down again, to be squeezed to our limits. Like this sponge, what if we were so filled with Jesus, the living water, that when we are squeezed and pressed, what comes out is Jesus. A pastor friend of mine showed me this illustration, and I like it because it shows us who we really are. Last year, when we lost our jobs, a loved one, when we were squeezed to our limit, what came out? Anger, hatred, regret, or were we so empty that nothing came out? If you fill yourself up with hate, when you are crushed and beaten down, what will come out, what others will see, is hate. Others will see who you really are. What have you filled yourself with? Are you ready to be squeezed and beaten down this year? Let us strive to be so filled with Jesus, the living water, that when the world punishes us, beats us down, and when we are squeezed to the breaking point, like this sponge, what comes out is Jesus. The world would do its best to break you down and beat you up, but we should be so filled with Jesus that when the world tries its best, what pours out of us into the world is forgiveness, grace, compassion, mercy, understanding, and love. May Jesus flow from us.